Alright, welcome back. We are on Spring 6, Year 1. I'm currently sitting with no money, some quests waiting, and as you can see, my levels so far. So I'm 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 levels for 6 days. Hopefully gonna pack another couple of these up.
Keep that curve going. My goal is to
be 2, 3, 4, somewhere around level. Total levels of 28 by the end of the season. That puts me in a really good spot, usually, assuming I've made cash as well. I have a buffer of cash at the end of the season. That summer becomes very, very lucrative, particularly if I have sprinklers. Obviously, social has not been a huge interest. It is Saturday, which I believe means either today or tomorrow he'll have a... No, tomorrow will be his gift day. So I need to watch out for that. It does show all of them. Nice. If I've met the person. Okay. Anyways. So, I'm gonna go fishing on this day, which means I'm gonna, after I water the crops, probably dump everything off about the pole. Just as a reminder, tomorrow will be clear and sunny, and today's luck is neutral. Ah, nice. There's some mail. Kill 10 slimes. Stone scattered around your farm. A well. Yeah, not gonna spend 1,000 gold for a well anytime soon. And I don't think I've ever actually built a well. Grab these two refined. Pop that off. Let's go ahead and drop all of those. At some point this tree will finish and then I'll cut it down. Energy constraints, that's why I will not be going to the mines, because that would be a very low profit. Go to the mines and basically dick around. Because I wouldn't be able to mine effectively. And I don't have the kind of currency yet in the game that I can just go buy for. Some copper bar. slide up here. Actually, I'm gonna go see if there's any spring onions. If there's any spring onions, that'll get me back to the game for today. Let's see if the sugar change is better. I really have enough crops now that I need to actually stop eating a lot of fish to get rid of my day efficiently. Which, using time well is more important than making a ton of money now. That I did make spreadsheets at one point, but I'm not going to be that anal about it. I just know what I need to do to be relatively efficient. I'm not going to put any more seeds in the ground on this day, so I'm not going to worry about fishing. Well, I've got the chest of lilies, so it is better to fish there. Fishing. I'll buy the backpack before I start mining. See if I can get it. I'll find it. It's an interesting one, too. I don't have to be making choices between items. It's perfect. Waiting for the noise. Ahead of the one per day average. 5 than I'm 2 ahead. Either way, good times. Full flounder. Full flounder. I'm gonna do the fish. Worth and I've still got a lot of fishing time left. Fishing Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, way back when I was a kid, when I played Warcraft, I spent a, World of Warcraft that is, I used to spend a ludicrous amount of time fishing. World of Warcraft. Stupid amount of time fishing, Red Dead Redemption 2 that is. Part that was just to get all the big fish. I didn't actually really like fishing in that game. I should give it a second shot, but my one more playthrough I've done, I didn't really enjoy the fishing too much in that, but I also didn't do it much. So, maybe it would grow on me if I did. I fished in. just to queue up for player versus player or for dungeons and just sit and fish while waiting. Used to make a during. This is the last time I did that. Would have been during the cataclysm. The last time I was in World of Warcraft and fished regularly. Played some of the expansions after that a little, but just, I don't know. I feel like the peak of Warcraft was Burning Crusades, probably. Just my personal opinion. And Cataclysm was making probably a couple grand gold a day fishing while waiting on PvP and dungeons, and I didn't even play very many hours. PvP for like 2 hours, maybe, today. The evenings. While waiting on the queue, I would just fish. But I knew where to fish for the most valuable items you could get from fishing. It wasn't even fish, and then I would just auction house them. And I would only auction house them. The levels in the auction house were low, or the prices were high. That way I could sort of control the market on my server. Of course you can't control the market, but you can play the market a little bit. Which is always a nice feeling. Yeah, I should really go drop these two. To make it. Well, we'll see what happens. I can always toss the newspaper. But yeah, I did four. So the fishing thing was mistake. Or if the fishing EXP has changed. I feel like I'm getting EXP slower than I remember. It may seem strange that I always pick up my tools, or try to always pick up my tools before I go to bed, but I've seen people who've, for whatever reason, got to walk out of their door, and a stone has spawned, or a piece of wood has spawned on the ground, and they're trapped in their cabin without their tools. And they literally have to, like, just sleep the days through until season change and hope that the thing's gone. Okay, so, reach level 2 farming, so yay proficiency. For sprinklers, I don't really like making these. I prefer to wait till you get gold, but we'll see how the season goes. And level 4 fishing, yay recycling machine, but I won't be making any yet. But once I can eventually, with the automation mod that I'm using. I know some people are like, no, only run vanilla, but I really like the automation mod. And I've played probably 7 or 8 playthroughs before adding any mods, so I understand the basic vanilla experience. I really like the basic vanilla experience. But the automation mod saves you a lot of time just doing menial things. So eventually you can get a bunch of crab pots, put them down, put if they're all touching each other, and then you have a chest touching one of the crab pots, and then you put recycling machines touching that chest, so that you have like a continuous circuit, if you will, and you put a whole bunch of bait in that chest. Every day it will move bait from the chest into the crab pots. Whatever those crab pots catch will be pushed back into the chest, and if any of it's trash, it will be pushed from the chest into the recycling machines, and so on. So you'll end up with whatever the crab pots caught for fish-wise, and then whatever was processed from the trash as well in that chest, and you just check it like once a week or so. So it's a pretty good mod. I like it a lot. Okay, so about 400 gold, or whatever the G is in this, for the fish. Most of it coming from sardines. So that was day 6 of spring, year 1. And some NR guys.